Welcome back. In this tutorial, we will cover wireframe and surface design commands and the related part design commands. So click on start, mechanical design, wireframe and surface design. Okay. Then at first we will see extrude command. So for that we will sketch one shape using sketch, select the plane, click on sketch and create some sketch to extrude. Then press escape and exit. Then click on extrude. Then you will have to give here the dimension, how much distance you want to extrude. And if you want to extrude on other side also, here you can place that dimension. If I want to extrude below by 10 and above by 20. And if you extrude by the same distance on both sides, you can use the mirror extent. So it will be extruded by 20 on either side. And if you want to change the direction of extrude, you can click on this reverse direction to change the direction. Then click on OK, cancel. Then if you don't want to view this curve, you can make it hide by clicking on this button, hide show, and click the curvature, so it will be invisible. Then suppose I want to cover this face, so for that you can use fill command, fill, then select this upper curvature and preview. So now this has covered in straight manner, but suppose I want some curvature into it, so for that you can here you can define the reference point so that this curve will pass through that point. So at first we will have to create that point, so you can create that point using this point command here. So click on point and define the coordinate. So this is 0 0 is here. Suppose I want some height in Z direction, suppose I will take 50, preview. So I will increase it a little bit, 70. Okay, so I want to then click on cancel. So I want to cover this surface with curve should pass through this point. So click on fill, then click this surface and passing point, click on this point and preview. So in this way it has created that curvature. And click on OK. Suppose I want to create one more extrude on this bottom horizontal plane only. So select the plane, horizontal plane, then sketch. Suppose here I want to create some extrude, or here also on this side. So normal. I will again create some shape here for extrude. Okay, then escape. So this shape is ready, exit. Then I want to extrude it, again extrude, and suppose I want to give 100 height, preview. Okay, alright, like this, and click on OK. So this extrude is created. Now I want to remove this shape and internal portion. So to remove, you can use the trim command. So click on this trim command here, trim, then select on this face and this face. So it is removing from inside and from below also. So it is giving a transparent effect, so that portion will be removed. And if you remove the other side, you can click here and select the other side to remove for both the elements. Which side you want to remove, you can select it by clicking on these buttons. So okay, I want to remove like this, okay, and cancel. So in this way this has been removed properly. and I don't want to view this shape, so click on this hide show and click on this shape. So in this way this has been removed. Then next I want to again cover this surface, so you can use the fill, select this surface, and if you want to give some point you can give the point, otherwise okay. So this portion has been covered. Then suppose now each entity is different, I want to combine these all surfaces and create single entity. So for that you can use the join option, join and select all the surfaces those you want to join and click on OK. Here we can view that, so it has created a single entity. So from this entity I want to create a 3D object, actually 3D model. So for that click on start, mechanical design, part design. So here there is a thick surface is there. If you want to create a hollow shape with thick surface, so click on that, select this surface and give the thickness. And here from here you can control the direction of the thickness. Now the thickness is inside. If you click on preview, so it has given the thickness from inside. If you click here OK, and if we hide the surface join, so in this way this thick part is created. And suppose if we want to give the thickness, suppose we will again make this joint visible. So for that you have to click on this swap visible space, then click on hide show and click on this surface, again click on this swap visible face. So surface model is again there. So double click on this thick surface. If you want to give some thickness on other side also, so here you can give the thickness on other side also. Click on preview, so it has thickness of 1 inside the surface and thickness of 2 outside the surface. By using the reverse direction you can interchange the thicknesses. And suppose if only single thickness is there, by reversing preview, by reversing you can bring it inside or send it outside the surface. So in this way you can use the thick surface. If you want to create a thick surface, suppose I don't want this thick surface, I will delete it. Okay, and then other one more option to convert into 3D is closed surface. If I want to create a complete 3D model, so click on this closed surface, then click on this join. Okay, so here the complete 3D model is created. So we will just hide the joint. So in this way this 3D model is created. Then there is one more option is there, that is split. You can split the 3D model using some surface. Suppose I will create one surface, so I will go back to start, mechanical design, wireframe and surface design, and on this vertical plane I will create one surface. Suppose I want to cut it in this way, escape, then exit, then again extrude, extrude mirror extent on both sides, I want to extrude it, then click on OK, then hide the curvature, hide, click on this curve. Okay, now using this curvature I will hide that point also, hide, click on the point. Okay, now using this surface I want to split the 3D object, so I will go back to mechanical design, part design, click on split, then click on the splitting element is this surface. Then from here you can define which portion of the part you want to keep it. If you want to keep it out upper part, arrow should be on that direction in which where you want to keep the, so I want to keep this bottom portion, so arrow is on this direction. Okay, and I will just hide this curvature, this surface. So in this way this part got created. So in this way you can use wireframe and part design combination to design your parts. So that's all. We will stop here. Thanks for watching the video.